Dear children, today I am going to explain you the poem Geography Lesson, which is lesson 2 in your book Honeydew. Okay, so let's get started. In this poem, the poet displays the concern for the division and friction among people. Means he is trying to explain that human beings are in habit of hating each other. They have enmity or feeling of jealousy from each other. Okay. Now, the poem begins with the poet seeing the city from the jet. The poet is traveling in an aeroplane, and when he looks down, what did he notice? He says that from that height, everything seems too small. When he looks down, he notices that each and everything that is present on the earth, it seems so small. He can see the full city properly. Now, from that particular height, he could see each and everything, not actually in a proper manner, but he could see. Also, he finds that the city is not properly planned and is disorganized, because he could see the larger part of the city in a small scale. That's why everything seems to be disorganized. Thus, it has no particular style. It means that it has no particular style. When the jet reached the height of 10,000 feet, he could see that the cities were located near the rivers or water resources. So, he realizes that the availability of water resources is the reason behind the unorganized city. Now, the cities grew as per the necessities. They settle near the water resources more because they require water for almost all their activities. He understands that the fertile land and water, these are the key to human existence. Without that, life is not possible. Thus, he can see the logical reason for the development of the cities. Then, drinking water, it is vital to human life. Water is necessary for almost all human activities, such as it is needed for agriculture, production, business, transport, and so many things, isn't it? He also now is clear that the earth has more water than land, and also that the earth is round. Lastly, he thinks that why have people on earth built walls, boundaries, and fences. The poet says that human beings have a lot of knowledge about the earth, that about its shape, the emergence of civilization, cities, nations, etc. So, but in this manner or in this quest, we have attained absolutely no knowledge about how to live peacefully on this amazing planet. He fails to understand that why do people hate each other so much? Building fences, building walls, building boundaries, it doesn't mean the wall makeup of bricks and all. It means we have made our heart so hard that we don't think about others. We don't have feeling for people. He feels that people are very selfish. They are jealous and have a narrow mindset. Okay. Also, he finds that the earth is one, but people living on it have divided and fragmented it. Now, he also feels that people on the planet are not living in harmony together for shallow reasons. The reasons are senseless. If people decide to forget their differences and stay together peacefully, this planet would be a wonderful, beautiful, and amazing place to live. And he also feels that people on the planet, they should love each other. They should not feel jealous or they should not hate. Isn't it? So the moral of the poem is, we shall use natural resources like land and water wisely. Also, we shall all live together in harmony and not fight with each other over unnecessary things or senseless things. In this way, we can make our earth a beautiful place to live in. ओके, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द ज्योग्राफी लेसन. थैंक यू.